Good evening, you're watching NDTV 24/7. Now, it's been more than a fortnight since Saudi Arabia began its strikes on Yemen. And since then, India has been busy trying to get its people back from the violence and the war that it was there. Now, India's got a pat on its back for its rescue operations from war-hit Yemen. Remember, India did not just evacuate Indians. There were people from as many as 17 countries who have been rescued by the Indian Navy and the Indian Air Force. And as the rescue operations wind up, NDTV's Vishnu Soam spoke with Group Captain B.S. Reddy, commander of the 81 Squadron, on this great feat.
Well, they're back from a splendid rescue operation where thousands of Indians have been rescued from Yemen, courtesy of the Indian Navy and the Indian Air Force. We are on board a C-17 transport of the Indian Air Force. They were operating from Djibouti in bringing across to India so many Indians who had been brought in over there by the Indian Navy. Well, joining us now, the squadron commander, to tell us a little bit more about these operations and also another pilot closely involved in the operations themselves. Sir, thank you very much for speaking to us. There've been fantastic stories of young children being rescued. What are some of those instances that come to your mind?
I had one instance wherein there was a mother of two. One was very young, almost baby in arms, and another one toddler. And she was probably alone, and she was finding it difficult to manage both through the rescue. And by the time she reached the aircraft, she was totally famished, and she couldn't even stand in the queue. So that was when I decided to pick the baby in arms and told her to sit down inside, out of the line. And that was a special moment that she was so thankful that she got to offload her troubles for a while before she could board the aircraft.
What about you? Is there anything that comes to mind? How did people thank you, for example?
People were really, really overwhelmed by the fact that they are being evacuated by their own country's force. There was one incident where some of the people came up and told us that it was not so easy to get into Sana'a airport, mm-hmm. to get back to India. They had to do multiple shuttles, and each time, because it is war-stricken country, they had to shell out a huge amount of money. Whatever they must have saved there must have gone on to just reach the airport.
Yeah.
And they were really thankful to get back to motherland. Yeah.
There was this one story I was told of a brother and a sister, right, who were separated. And then on your aircraft they'd come together, right, after being separated for several days.
Yeah, that's true. And that was after a wait of almost 4 to 5 hours, probably out of the ship. Normally, when they come out of the ship, they are divided into two lots, the two separate C-17 missions, and that's probably when they were separated. And back at the airport, in the launch, when they saw each other, they were really elated.
Yeah. And you never ultimately got to fly into Yemen. You were doing all your rescues from Djibouti, bringing people back. That's a regret of yours, because you feel this aircraft and your men and women were prepped to go into a wartime scenario.
Yes, that's always a scenario in these situations. Even earlier from Libya, when we were trying to evacuate the Indians in the crisis, we were also again forced to cool off our heels in Cairo. In fact, in the end of it, we just got one shipload of passengers out of Alexandria. In the same manner, we were more than prepared and eager to get in and rescue, because they would make much more difference than an Airbus at that altitude, especially while they could step up their performance to about 200 plus, would have easily got out 300 plus each time and wrapped up the whole mission probably in 3 or 4 days.
All right, well, sir, thank you very much, and congratulations to you as well. There you have it, just a couple of accounts of what so many Indians went through over there, but courtesy the Indian Air Force and the Indian Navy, they're all back home now. It's been a splendid rescue mission, and hopefully this kind of performance can be replicated in the future as well. It's been one of the most remarkable rescue operations in recent times, where the Indian Air Force and the Indian Navy have done remarkable work in saving the lives of thousands of Indians who were stranded in Yemen. Behind me are the men who, from the Air Force, were responsible in flying their C-17 aircraft, which you can see behind me, to Yemen, a war-struck country, in ensuring that so many Indian lives could be saved. It's been a very, very difficult operation for all sorts of reasons, and I'm going to try and find out what some of those reasons were. Sir, congratulations, and thank you so much for speaking to us. The group captain has been leading these men in these operations. He commands this particular squadron. Sir, when you first went in over there, did you ever expect that you would end up rescuing several hundred, if not thousand, Indians?
Yes, initially we started with just two aircraft, and as the operation picked up, we were tasked to induct a third aircraft. So what looked like a 3 to 4 day operation extended to 10 days with us evacuating as many 2,095 passengers out in 11 missions, flying about 152 hours. And that was about twice what we expected when we were initially given the go for this operation.
And you were operating in hostile airspace. What were some of the problems with air traffic control?
Per se, in Djibouti, it was not as difficult because it was not in active combat zone. However, just to avoid any issues and overflight clearance problems, we did take a circuitous route going through Somalia. Otherwise, per se, in Djibouti, there was no battle issue.
Okay, but what about Yemen?
Yemen, actually we regret the fact that we did not get the clearance to go all the way into Yemen. As it always happens, we had to cool off our heels in Djibouti for clearance issues, just like it always happens.
Right. And let me just come across to some of the other officers and men over there. Why don't I ask you a question first? What was the experience like for you to be part of an operation where you're responsible for saving so many lives? What did it feel like? How intense was it all for you?
It was very satisfying to go there and see our brothers and sisters who were stuck in those countries, war zone areas, to get them alive here and to make them meet their parents and their sisters and brothers. It was a very satisfying job.
All right. And why don't you tell us, what were some of the big challenges that you faced in the operations?
One of the biggest challenge was sustenance of the operation for such a long duration because of the sheer time that is involved in each mission. Mm-hmm. And after landing there was a certain amount of uncertainty as to how many people are coming. It was a sea of people coming into Djibouti, and we had to wait for long hours to sort out their passports and visas and get them on board. Once we got them on board, it was really a satisfying experience flying them back home.
Yeah. What about the aircraft itself? The fact that you had to sustain operations constantly, how difficult or how challenging was that?
We are trained for that and we were prepared. It was a bit hectic, but we are geared up for all the situations, for all the problems to face it. And it was very satisfying for all of us in uniform. We are made for that. And it was a pleasure when seeing the Indian citizen coming back, landing at Cochin and Bombay and meeting their relatives. It was a very satisfying job.
Tell us a little bit about the aircraft itself. It's a new aircraft in the Indian Air Force. It has a huge responsibility to play, particularly in roles like this. How did the capability of the C-17 help you in your operations?
The C-17, as we all know, is an unprecedented, predisposed, unchallenged aircraft anywhere in the world today. We have been trained on this aircraft, and we are the very first ones to be trained. For last 2 years, we've been planning for contingencies like this. And it is this mighty hero right behind us that made us rise to the challenges today. And we only played our part operating this machine. It was this beautiful machine that lived up to its name of being omnipresent, powerful, and ubiquitous.
What about you? Anything that you remember about people thanking you or being grateful for your presence?
The youngest that I saw was a 70-year-old gentleman, and the oldest I saw was a 7-month young boy. And they were very happy to get back to their families, their near ones and dear ones. A peculiar case that comes to my mind is the story of a brother and sister. They got lost between themselves at Yemen, and they were united by the Indian Navy, and we ferried them back home. No other feeling can match this. They extremely satisfied.
They got lost in Yemen.
They got lost in Yemen, and they were reunited by the Indian Navy on board their ship, and we brought them home to Cochin.
How old were they? I mean, roughly.
They were about, the girl was about 18 and the boy was about 20, 21.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, remarkable stories over there. In fact, I'm going to put some more of questions on this to you. Aap bataiye hamein, sir. What were some of the stories that you came across of people being rescued? What did they tell you?
Normally in such type of rescue operations we find they haven't seen these aircraft like Globemasters, so they and then when they see that the Indians are coming to rescue us, they feel really very pleased, and we also feel very satisfied when we do such type of rescue operations, whether it is in outside country or within country. For example, like J&K recently we did, same way we feel really satisfying doing a national task of such nature.
Yeah. Anything that came to mind for you as far as of people thanking you?
Yeah, in one of the sorties, we had around 15 people, the elderly people, and they were sugar patient, and some 10 to 15 small kids, and they said they are without food since 6 o'clock in the morning, and we are getting airborne around 8 o'clock in the evening, and they were not given any food outside. So we whatever we had at our disposal, biscuits, mixture or other food, we given to the kids, ladies, and particularly those people having sugar patient. So because if they don't take food, they will be lack of sugar,
yeah,
and they may faint.
Yeah.
So they were very thankful, and we see the smile and that smile on their face, and we felt very happy for that.
Yeah. And how many aircraft did you actually employ in this operation constantly?
We initially began with 2 aircrafts, wherein the 3rd aircraft was also added in the mission. And whenever a mission was over, the task was whichever aircraft was down, it was to be prepared. So in totality, we had employed around 6 aircrafts for this whole rescue operation.
Okay. And we've got almost the entire flight line behind us.
Yes, that's correct. And the amount of flying hours we did and was tremendous. We flew close to around 152 hours in those 7-8 days. Initially started with 2 aircraft, then again because there were so many evacuees, we had to put in one more aircraft, but all of us did the very good job.
All right. Well, it's been a proud privilege for all of us at NDTV to be interacting with these men who've done yeoman service as far as rescuing thousands of Indians in Yemen are concerned. The Indian Navy played a decisive role as well. And this is actually a fairly rare sight. Almost the entire lineup of C-17 transports of the Indian Air Force, recently inducted aircraft, actually just behind us. And in a few moments from now, on my left, you're going to see a C-17 which has just landed over there. And this flight line will almost be completed over there. All of these aircraft having participated in operations like this in many parts of the country, and some of these aircraft participating in those operations in Djibouti, in rescuing people who'd come across from Yemen.